I appreciate you getting the time today.
No problem, mate. What is it? Do you want to do some training?
Yeah, back. Go for a back workout. Got a show in 2 weeks. Got fly back to the UK for the British for junior.
Okay.
So back.
So your calorie intense. Obviously restricted at the moment.
Low, yeah. Yeah. Gone zero carb from today for a week. Gonna deplete. Feel good. I don't feel too bad.
But push you a little bit. You know,
listen, I want to go blood and guts though, mate.
All right. I normally wouldn't recommend like going too deep into the
2 weeks out, you know, whatever you recommend.
Yeah,
for that,
yeah. Well,
you might want the best
one step at a time, yeah.
Yeah.
Because back's the hardest part of the body to train properly, actually. Even pros.
And you
can see
they're not
training properly.
Yeah.
Okay, it's genetics, it's hard work, but it's also technique as well. If you're not doing the correct technique, you're not going to contract the lats properly, which is what I see all the time. So definitely think you could benefit from that. So give me a couple of minutes. If you want to do a little general warm up,
do a little rotator cuff activation.
Yeah.
Maybe a light
set of pull down, something. Just get blood in the area. I'll be a couple of minutes.
Perfect. Just a message to my friends, my family, really. Final few words before my session with Dorian. If I don't make it out alive, I love everyone. And it's been great. Let's go. Sets of pull-ups and then a few sets of pull-downs to warm up the lats, fully stretch and activate.
Exercises you're doing, whether it's a pull down, rows, it's all going through there, right? As that's a small muscle, that could fail before those guys have failed, yeah? So we need to try to exhaust the lats without involving the biceps at first, yeah? So we're gonna go there in a minute, but before that, I just wanna do a light set to do that, because I want you to feel how it should feel when you get a full contraction in the lats, yeah? And in order to get a full contraction in the lats, your spine has to be a little bit arched. Yeah? If you're rounded like this, you're not contracting your lats, you need to be here, yeah? At the top, it doesn't matter, I don't care what you do there, yeah? But when you come down and you pull and you contract, it should be a slight arch. Any movement, yeah?
That's where so many people, you see so many different arguments and whatnot.
Well, it's not an argument, it's just fact, yeah?
Yeah, that's good.
Know, look it up.
You can't fact check the king.
Look it up. And what's the function of the lats? It's important that you like get this connection in your mind to the muscle. What does it do? It brings the upper arms down and back. So this, down and back, yeah? So it could be here, going down and back, yeah? Upper arm here, versus down and back. Could be here, going down and back. Could be here. Relative to the torso, going down and back, yeah? And the contraction there, you have to have a little arch in the spine, yeah? And you should be able to hold it. There's three levels of strength on this particular exercise, anyway. You've got the positive. That's the weakest part of the movement, although that's what people really primarily concentrate on, yeah? That's the weakest part of the movement. The static hold, that's stronger than the positive, yeah? Yeah? And the negative is the strongest part of the movement, yeah? So most people are just concentrating on this. They're not pausing, they're not statically contracting, they're not slowing the negative down, right? So this is why high intensity training is low volume. because you've got to make every set count in every way. Not just about throwing heavy weights around, it's about controlling that weight, it's about putting as much stress as you can on those muscles that you're trying to train, which in this case is mainly the lats, yeah? Alright, so it's going to look like this. Reverse grip, first of all. If you're going to do pull downs, I recommend the reverse, fairly close grip, because going to get more stretch then. People used to
I've
say,
I've always preferred closer because I've got a narrower.
You're going to get more range of motion, look. Here, all the way down. Yeah, right, you're out here. It's a short motion and the biceps are not in a good pulling position, so I don't do any.
Do you like the T-bar as well?
It's okay, but I feel with the supinated grip, I've got a little bit more power rather than the parallel grip, but it's not a big deal. If you feel it works better, it's okay. So, first of all, I don't need to do this with my biceps, totally extend them. I'm extending my upper arm, so there's a little bend there. Come down, pause, control, pull, pause, control. That kind of cadence, yeah?
How many reps?
Just 8 reps, I'm just warming up, man, for you to feel how this should feel when it gets heavy. Getting your connection there, yeah? Lats are coming from up here, down here. That's it. Slow. And go. Good, perfect. So you feel at the bottom, it's like a little cramping here, right? The bottom of your lats, yeah? So now you know what you should feel all the time, even when it gets heavy and your body's wanting you to break that form to bring other muscles into play, you've got to override that, yeah? Keep the form, and if you need assistance, I'm going to help you. One more. Nice. Okay? So you feel that, right? That's what you should feel in all the exercises.
Feeling it straight
away. Sorry?
Feeling it straight away.
Right, just down the bottom there. That's the bottom of your lats, yeah? Right, let's move over here. Okay.
You got something you're doing?
I want to just pull over the machine. So, the reason I like that is it's
close to the speed.
It's going from here all the way down, so 180 degrees, no bicep involvement. So,
there's no linear movements.
It's as isolated as you can get for the bicep, for the lats, yeah? So, you're going to sit here, back against the backboard, yeah? Push this down, it's going to bring the carriage over. So your upper arms go in against these pads.
Yeah.
Yeah, depending on your arm length and everything, you could have your hands here, like from here.
Does it matter on the average?
No, because you're not pulling there, yeah? You're driving through these pads, right? If you move your arm like there, you're going to be, not a tricep, static contraction, yeah? So you want to put them in there so we're not contracting the triceps too much. Sit down. Stretch up. All the way down, hold. Control. And you find the last bit of the movement is the hardest, so that's where you're going to fail eventually, and I'll help you with that, yeah? Okay. Well, there's a pad somewhere.
Sorry, I'll still play. Too short.
He's got one or two.
Seat,
you know?
I think one should be alright.
Alright, yeah.
I hope so, otherwise my ego's gonna be seriously crushed.
Well, you know you're in the right position. Alright. Upper arms in there. Yeah, that'll do. Okay. Take your feet off there. Cool. Stretch up. Up, 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 and down. Drive. Good. One. Two. That's it. All range. Come on. Three. Keep that on the pad, yeah? Let's go. Four. Drive. Five. Drive. Six. Two more. Push. Seven, and again. Push. roll it up. Got it? Yeah, it feels a bit strange at first, especially that last bit of movement.
Yeah. It's nice though.
Pure lats.
Yeah, nice.
So what's going to happen is your lats are going to get exhausted, pre-exhausted, and the biceps and brachialis are still relatively fresh when we go to the second exercise. You'll get more out of that than if you did it at first.
Yeah. And I'm going to put another pad on there and admit that I'm
4 foot
11.
Yeah.
It's just better when you're higher up.
So hold on this side, you stay there.
Just going to put this on for now.
See how you feel with that bit of height. You know what I mean? This belt is not the best, but
it's fine.
It helps a little bit.
No, that's better.
All right. Sit back, man. Okay. So, one. Two. Get the elbows in there, that's better. Three. Four. Drive through the pads. Five. Three more, come on. Six. Push. Seven. And again. Push, 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 push. Slow. All right, got it. Okay, come on. Push a bit more now. In there, yeah? On there all the time. Ready? Yours. One. Two. Three. Good. Hold it to the bottom. Let's pause. Four, hold it there. Okay, again now. Drive. Right, hold it there. Three more. Push. Squeeze it in, squeeze it in. Yeah, that's it. Two more like that. Come on, I'm with you. Let's go. Lats, squeeze elbows through the pads, push them through. One more, last one, everything we got here. Stretching up and driving through. Come on, drive through the pads, crush it. Squeeze it in, squeeze it in, squeeze it in. Whoa. All right, maybe not slow.
much better there.
Yeah, it's a little bit of stability.
Staying.
Yeah. Good. All right, so now you're pretty exhausted. I'm sure, you know, if you were not light before a contest, you'd be heavier and I'd push you, but I don't want to.
Zero carb
zone that you can't recover.
Yeah, there's no point. As you got to go, you've got to train within your current capability. So my food at the minute's low to make condition. So I'm not going to be pushing as crazy weight. I'm going to be focusing solely on contraction. And like Dorian says, the execution of every movement, as opposed to just load, load, load. That's more off season. Now's about detailing, contraction, and actually sculpting.
Well, you know, you're cruising now, man, and just maintaining. You're not going to build any muscle the last 2 weeks, so just training enough to maintain.
Good, good,
yeah,
good.
Next, we're going to do the pull down again, yeah? Cool. Now that the lats are pre-exhausted, as we are bringing the biceps in, let's do one that's, one submaximal. Yeah, on the second set, this one. Use the straps only when you're becoming an issue, otherwise if you support it all the time, it'll
get weaker.
Okay. See you Friday, man.
Let's make another picture.
Sure. Okay.
Anyone got a picture of this?
Don't worry.
Thank you.
All right, man. Have a good one. Okay, so no straps, as it's going to be easy enough. Same grip. You're going to feel it more now. Your lats are pretty close. Go. Okay. One. Good. Two. Nice. Stretch. Three. Stretch. Four. Five. Six. Pull. Seven. Okay. Relax. Nice. Just make sure when it gets heavier now that you don't start using any body momentum or body movement to help assist. It's a natural thing that kicks in if you're not careful.
Yeah. It's when I saw my training improve the most, when I was thinking so precisely about everything I do. Is this correct? Am I holding it long enough? got my rushing things, and it's easy to get complacent. But you start building tissue, you think you know it all, but you never stop learning. Never stop fucking learning.
Well, I think the misconception that people had about my training is it's about heavy weights. Yeah, I used heavy weights, but in a very pyramid
kind
way.
Of approach.
Yeah, but control.
Yeah.
You know, controlling the negative, using no momentum. If you want to lift more weights, yeah, then you can use momentum
ranges,
to use your body, you know?
Yeah, rep ranges and weights mean fuck all. Your execution isn't right because it's not doing anything correct. So.
Right, get your straps ready, yeah?
Of course.
DY, baby.
Only the best.
You're going to get stronger if you put the DY straps on.
It's actually scientifically proven.
Yeah, 10% according
increase. According to scientific studies, you increase your strength by 10% by wearing blood and gut straps.
And we're going to lock you in, so your grip's not going to be an issue, it's just going to go until the lats fail. Yeah, at some point your lats are going to have to take a grip at some point. Okay? In. Okay, keep your body still, yeah? Just the lats. The lats are going to do the work, yeah? Go to the lats and forward with the lats. Perfect now, keep it like that. Three. Stretch. Four. Four, it's all yours. Five. Squeeze it in. Six, all yours. Come on. Four. Seven's yours. Stretch, pull. All the way. Come on, two more. Pull, squeeze it in there. One more, don't lean back. Keep pulling. Four, perfect, yes. One more, that was better. Stronger, come on. This one's stronger. Pull. Okay, one more, because I was sloppy, man. Fucking keep still. Pull with the lats. Pull. Just pull, 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 pull. Squeeze it there, hold it there, slow. Yes, that's better. Good job, man. Yeah, you tried to kick some momentum in there in one of those reps, yeah?
Tried to kick momentum and we nearly got a kick in the head.
You've got to override that. You know, your body's going to try and find it either way, always. You've got to like, be the boss here and say, no, no, you're staying at this range of motion. And if I get to failure, I don't need to use momentum because I have a training partner there. It won't help just to get through, yeah? Okay, so we're going to do a bent over row. Which I started to do differently to target the lats more. The conventional bent over row was more like parallel to the floor, coming up to the, you know, to the abdomen or the chest area, working more of the upper back, yeah, but I wanted to work more of the lats and the lower trapezius, so I started doing the rows more upright, about here, yeah. So about this position, the bar is going to be about by your knees. Your back is in this strong, safe position and it doesn't move. A lot of people start with this, you know, this is momentum, yeah, I'm going to cut that out. So lock your legs, lock your back, this is the position. Your legs don't move, your back don't move. Just pull from here, into the waist and down. That's the movement, yeah. Okay. Alright, let's see if we can get that position locked. Good. One, two, three, kick head up. Four, that's better. In the mirror. Five, perfect. Six, seven, eight, two more. Pull. Pull. Perfect, and down. Good. Just a little tip with the head, yeah? Because as we were discussing earlier, the spine needs to be a little bit arched, yeah? And if you put the head down and look at the floor, what happens?
Yeah.
The spine goes with it, yeah? If you've got your head up a little bit, not cricking your neck, but just up a little bit, keep an eye in the mirror. You can't, I mean, keep your head up and try to arch your back.
Yeah.
You can't do it, it doesn't work, yeah? So, that's a good tip to keep your, maintain your position. Yeah? I'm gonna go 10 kilos more, 15, make sure there's no body, no leg movement, yeah? Same as a lasso, yeah? Locked in.